Welcome back to the next episode of the Landmarque Show. Today we're challenging the conventional notions of ambition and success, again, particularly in South Africa. We have unique socioeconomic landscapes here in this country. Is it not time to rethink these concepts and really challenge what they truly mean? In a world where economic success often reigns supreme, it's easy to equate ambition with financial gain. Somehow those two are always tied together. But let's broaden our perspective a little bit. Imagine valuing other things like resilience, like creativity and impact on society, just as much as we value financial gain or financial success and personal wealth. A study in 2023 said that less than 30% of South Africans equated success with high income or material possessions. Instead, many highlighted factors like family happiness, community impact, and personal fulfillment. This is suggesting a growing shift in how we define achievement. Did you know that globally, there is a rising trend to redefine success? For instance, in the Nordic countries, success is often linked to the quality of life, social support, work-life balance, and not just personal wealth. And this is a stark contrast to the more materialistic measures of success often seen in other parts of the world for pretty much the last half century. What if our own society embraced a similar model? What if success also encompassed being able to contribute positively to communities or to innovate for betterment of society or to find joy and satisfaction in our daily lives? While Western narratives often focus on individual achievements and wealth, or even wealth accumulation, many African and Eastern traditions often emphasize collective well-being and personal contentment, which kind of offers a more holistic view of success, one that balances personal aspiration with societal well-being. What if education, health, and housing were guaranteed? What if we were free to pursue ambitions beyond material success? What if nobody cared what car you drive, where you live, and the fashion that you wear, and the watch on your wrist? What would be the thing consuming all of our time if all those things were guaranteed? What if those things were not even differentiators like they are today? What role would ambition play? What would success even mean if all those basics were covered? As we wrap up, let's envision a future where success is measured by a wider array of standards before it. Anyway, how do you define success in your life? Is it time to shift our collective mindset to embrace a more inclusive and a more humane definition of ambition and achievement? As always, I'm Landmarque, and I'm out.